Yes, sir, we promised you a great main event here tonight. Look at that here.
Andre.
The Giant.
WrestleMania.
Everyone has a price.
Rest.
My God, what a
ride. It's the man.
You're fired.
Get the hell down.
It's not over.
The world is watching.
NXT rookies, 8 WWE pros, 1 dream.
We are wild and young, and we have just begun. So slow it down, you move a little too fast. You take a deep breath, you make this last. Hey, you should be the best.
The WWE's next breakout star.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, an uneasiness is settled over the St. Pete Times Forum in Tampa tonight as we kick off season 2 of NXT. Almost an air of paranoia here, perhaps. Because of what happened last night on Monday Night Raw. With more in the start of this second season, we head up to our host, Matt Stryker.
Ladies and gentlemen, last night live on Monday Night Raw, the graduating class from the first season of NXT made a bombastic impact, destroying and injuring everything and anything in their path. The question is now, will the second season of NXT choose to follow suit? We're all gonna find out together. Welcome to season 2 of NXT! Now, please join me in welcoming your NXT season 2 WWE pros!
Awesome!
I came to the game to play, there's a price to pay.
He's back! The Vince Lombardi of NXT! The Phil Jackson!
Allow me to introduce to you WWE's next breakout star, my rookie, Alex Riley!
What I know about Alex Riley, this pairing should really get along.
The Miz is very excited about his NXT rookie, Alex Riley. The Miz telling anyone that will listen that Alex Riley will win NXT Season 2.
Well, they both have huge egos, like each other. I like to call him the Monday Night Delight. From Raw, John Morrison.
It's Tuesday.
Yeah, but he's on Raw Mondays.
Of all the rookies in NXT Season 2, my rookie is definitely the tallest. Give it up for Eli Cottonwood!
And Josh, not only is Eli Cottonwood the tallest, he may be the oddest. I believe Eli's a fry short of a Happy Meal.
Over 7 feet tall and 300 pounds, the biggest of the NXT Season 2 rookies is Eli Cottonwood.
He's a little strange.
Yeah, I tried to stay away from Eli Cottonwood today.
Weird may be the best way to describe him.
Cody Rhodes!
Hey.
Husky Harris.
Well, judging by that introduction, I don't believe Cody Rhodes is that enthused about his rookie Husky Harris. But an interesting story, a story about this pairing, which we'll tell you a little bit later on tonight here on NXT.
Self-professed
pro women's champion.
Cool.
It's the rookie you've all been waiting for.
Well, Caval has performed all over the globe, and I cannot wait to see what relationship is going to develop between this young man from Brooklyn, New York, and the first ever female pros.
I feel sorry for Caval. The most intriguing matchup, in my opinion, of rookie and pros.
Why would you feel sorry? They're the self-professed women's champions.
The world's strongest man! Mark Henry!
He's not the world's strongest rookie, but he's lucky. Lucky Cannon!
Lucky, a former sheriff's deputy from here in Florida. Seems to be enthused about his pairing with the world's strongest man.
Lucky's excited to be here in front of the entire WWE Universe. Young man enthusiastic about being a part of NXT.
The Intercontinental Champion, Kofi Kingston!
Ladies and gentlemen, get to your feet, make some noise for my rookie, Michael McGillicuddy.
Well, McGillicuddy is a third generation superstar. His father, Mr. Perfect, Kurt Hennig, a former Intercontinental Champion, and now McGillicuddy is paired with the current Intercontinental Champion, Kofi Kingston.
There's no question that the WWE is in the DNA of Michael McGillicuddy. We'll see how McGillicuddy does here with NXT. Nobody can stop me, nobody can hold me,
nobody can MVP! MVP is in the building! And so is my rookie, Showtime, Percy Watson.
Now, what I like about this pairing, Josh, is they're from the neighborhood together, both from South Beach in Miami here in Florida, and Percy is very entertaining.
Showtime, Percy Watson, certainly full of personality.
Look at MVP trying to keep him down a bit.
Percy hasn't stopped dancing yet.
He's pumped up. If it wasn't for the man, Zach, be my favorite coach.
Back. Here's my new bro, Titus O'Neil.
Well, you told me earlier, Cole, that Zack Ryder doesn't deserve to be a pro here on NXT. I strongly disagree with you. We'll see if Titus O'Neil becomes a part of the Zack Pack.
Well, this will be a very interesting pairing. Titus is an athlete through and through. Great guy, but when he's pushed, he can get completely out of control from what we understand. How much of Zack Ryder's antics, Titus is going to be able to handle.
Woo, 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 bro. Zack Ryder calls himself Woo Z because he makes the ladies woozy.
Yo. Take a look at this cast of characters for NXT Season 2.
Gentlemen, why don't you spread out? Let the camera get a good look at you. This is NXT. Last season, the NXT rookies were evaluated by the WWE pros. This season, we're going to even things up a little bit. Only 50% of the evaluation will fall into the responsibility of the WWE pros. The other 50% will rest with you, the WWE Universe. You will have an opportunity to go to WWE.com and vote for or against whichever rookie you feel will become the WWE's next breakout star. Rookies, pay attention. Season two is going to be very different than season one. Season two will only be 12 weeks long, so the pressure is intense. In 3 weeks' time, the WWE pros will cast their very first pros poll, and you, the WWE Universe, will cast your first vote as well. Gentlemen, ladies, in 6 weeks' time, we will have our first elimination as we get closer and closer to finding out who will follow Wade Barrett and become the WWE's next breakout star. Who will go on to earn a championship match live on pay-per-view? Rookies, pros, your opportunity to impress begins right now, because WWE pros and WWE rookies will be in action next on NXT.
I'll tell you what's next. Me, Goons, Goons. I'm gonna rock this joint. NXT is
not. Uh-oh. Husky Harris getting into it. Now the rookies. Some pushing and shoving.
WWE Fatal 4-Way. Three men with nothing to lose. One champion with everything at stake. The champ, John Cena, defends the WWE Championship against Randy Orton, Edge, and the Celtic Warrior Sheamus. Plus, Rey Mysterio, The Big Show, and CM Punk challenge Jack Swagger for the World Heavyweight Championship. The risk is high, and the reward even higher. WWE Fatal 4-Way.
Welcome back to the season premiere of NXT Season 2, but we have to address what happened last night, because there really is an uneasiness that has come across this arena here in Tampa tonight. 24 hours ago, the eight graduates from NXT Season 1 came into the arena. They entered the ring. They attacked WWE champion John Cena. But not only Cena, they assaulted, they mugged, they mauled employees of World Wrestling Entertainment, announcers, ring announcers, security, timekeepers. In fact, I managed to get away, and as I was walking through the crowd, you could hear the WWE fans, how emotional they were about this. There were children crying in the stands, trying to make sense of what happened last night.
Michael, it was catastrophic. It was unprecedented. It was uneasy to watch, and let's just hope that something like that doesn't happen here tonight on NXT.
Well, again, we will try to refocus tonight, ladies and gentlemen. This is a pros and rookies tag team matchup. It is John Morrison teaming with his rookie Eli Cottonwood against Zack Ryder and his rookie Titus O'Neil. And the pros, Ryder and Morrison, start things off. And Josh, let's take a look at who's on the stage here, the pros who are evaluating this matchup.
Well, the pros watching, taking a close look here at this first match of NXT Season 2, a very important match to find out which rookie and pro combination will get out of the gates first. Look at the size of Eli Cottonwood.
Yeah, our first look at the 7 foot, 315 pounder from Wisconsin, Eli Cottonwood, who now goes face to face with fellow rookie Titus O'Neil.
Interesting to note that the pro, Zack Ryder, wanted nothing to do with Eli Cottonwood.
Well, different dichotomy in these two individuals. Cottonwood once played pro basketball. Titus O'Neil once played pro football with the Jacksonville Jaguars. In fact, he played at the University of Florida for the Gators.
Titus O'Neil also the
Cover him!
Big man's down.
Here we go, Titus with a cover on Cottonwood and a kick out.
Do the dog bark!
Titus O'Neil, well, they're trash talking, and Cottonwood's not going to stand for it. Eli Cottonwood, who admits he's trying to adjust to things here, and first opportunity on NXT, tags in his pro, John Morrison.
John Morrison will certainly get Eli Cottonwood out of his shell, as Cottonwood and Morrison are on the same page right now. Can they keep it going? We'll find out when NXT returns.
Come on, you're right.
Hi, this is WWE Diva Eve Torres with an important message for the entire WWE universe. WWE superstars are professionally trained performers. The moves we do in the ring take years of practice to perfect and to do safely. I urge the entire WWE universe to never try to copy what we do in the ring, at home or at school. Stay safe. Don't try this.
We're back on NXT. This is a pros versus rookie tag team matchup. Zack Ryder teaming with his rookie Titus O'Neil against John Morrison and Eli Cottonwood.
Two pros in the ring right now, and Zack Ryder and John Morrison.
And look at John Morrison go. Remember last night, these two involved in a matchup on the Viewer's Choice show of Raw, kick out by Zack Ryder. Zack Ryder was voted in by our fans to be a tag team partner of The Miz. John Morrison voted in the team with R-Truth.
Now Zack Ryder makes the tag to big Titus O'Neil. Ryder wants to teach O'Neil how to pick up chicks, dress, and get zacked, whatever that means.
Morrison off that kick, hooks the leg now on O'Neil. Ew, and it's Zack Ryder breaking up the possible three count. Cottonwood with a big boot. And there goes Ryder. Oh, look at Morrison. This could be it. Starship Pain connects. Welcome to the WWE, Titus O'Neil.
Here are your winners, John Morrison and Eli Cottonwood.
Were you able to get any feel for these young rookies in this first matchup here tonight?
I have a feeling that Eli Cottonwood might be perhaps the most intense of all these NXT rookies. You see the way John Morrison is keeping his eyes on Cottonwood, but nonetheless, Eli 1-0 on NXT.
Hey, John Morrison, as a pro, give me your first-hand opinion of your rookie, Eli Cottonwood.
Big man held his own tonight. What'd you guys think of Eli Cottonwood tonight? I go by what the people say. A lot of people happy with him. Some people not so happy, but everybody had an opinion. I think that's what matters.
Let's hear from some of the pros on the stage. How about The Miz?
As far as I'm concerned, you guys had an opportunity to impress the audience, to entertain us, to show us who you are as WWE superstars, as NXT rookies. Do you really think that you impressed anyone tonight? I'm not entertained. You failed.
Okay, I'm sure we're gonna hear more from you as the evening goes on. NXT continues with this.
Well, that's why I love The Miz. The Miz is so outspoken. That's why Miz should be in the Hall of Fame of coaches here on NXT. He's like Bill Parcells.
You are out of your mind.
Why? Daniel Bryan, remember, was ranked number one before he eliminated himself in season one.
All right, just talk about The Miz. Go ahead, and the way you feel about Daniel Bryan. Do you have anything else you want to say? Anything else you want to get off your chest?
Not right now.
You sure? Well, with that said, we're going to meet another one of our NXT rookies. He is The Miz's NXT rookie, Alex Riley.
Does my hair look all right?
Of course it looks all right. Why am I asking you for it?
We get lunch, right? Can we get this thing going? I got to meet my girlfriend for a martini. My name is Alex Riley. I am from Georgetown, Virginia. You know, I wish sometimes that I had a Rocky Balboa story or a sob story to tell you, but that's not how my life was. I was very fortunate as a young man. I don't have a problem admitting that. My mother was Miss Virginia, and my father was a New York Jet and went on to be a very well-known ESPN analyst for college football and NFL football. I drive nice cars. I have nice clothes. My parents are great. I'm the rare breed. Instead of NXT, you might as well call this show Alex Riley and the Seven Dorks, because that's what it's gonna be. I was a tri-sport athlete. I won a state championship in the state of Virginia. I played football at Boston College and excelled. I've been signing my autograph
since I was 16 years old. As a matter of fact, why don't we just get this out of the way? Here it is. Alex Riley, dot the I. Now you don't have to ask for it on the street, okay? Just leave me alone. The world's already gotten it. I'm tailor-made, born to be a WWE champion. Looks, mic skills, athletic ability, a rare breed of all those things. The WWE universe might as well buy a plane and write this in the sky, and if they can't afford one, I'll loan them mine. Alex Riley has arrived, and he's running the show. Now, is this all over? Because I got dinner reservations. You're dismissed.
Ladies and gentlemen, still to come tonight, we will take you back to the uncomfortable, the disturbing, the frankly scary scene at the culmination of Monday Night Raw. The assault that shook this company's entire foundation, its psyche. We'll show you this later tonight. We are back on NXT. Two more rookies, Josh, get to prove what they're all about in this Rookies and Pros tag team matchup.
That's season two of NXT. It's MVP and his rookie showtime, Percy Watson. Percy Watson wants to start the matchup. And there you see Husky Harris on the outside of the ring, the rookie. And the pro, Cody Rhodes, will start for his team.
What I find interesting about this Cody Rhodes-Husky Harris pairing is that last night, on the first ever Viewer's Choice edition of Monday Night Raw, we saw Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, give the bionic elbow to IRS. Well, his son Cody Rhodes is involved in this matchup. His rookie, the son of IRS, Husky Harris.
Ain't that something, Cole?
Isn't it? Pretty amazing.
6 degrees of separation by Michael Cole.
Nonetheless, this is Cody Rhodes starting things off in this matchup against Showtime, Percy Watson.
Percy Watson, go ahead, Cole.
I was going to say he's from South Beach.
There you go. I was going to say that too. What else you got?
He's got an awesome body, a Fortune 500 CEO mind.
You notice that Percy Watson competes with his glasses on?
Yeah. Probably because he can't see without them.
Contacts or laser eye surgery?
Hey, remember Urkel starred in a television show and he wore glasses.
1986 called.
Nonetheless, Showtime Percy Watson, a great athlete, once played pro football with the Packers and the Redskins. Likes to say that he's, quote, chill.
Clean break.
Percy Watson wanted to be a model, but he decided that wasn't physical enough for him. So Percy Watson trying to here compete in the WWE on NXT Season 2.
And looks at Watson up over the top and falls up with a clothesline to Cody Rhodes. Cody Rhodes, dominating Watson at this juncture. Watson goes 6'3", 235 pounds. And for the first time, Josh, we get to see Husky Harris.
What can you say about Husky Harris that you can't see physically on the screen? A third generation rookie.
He's Husky.
Perhaps a more athletic Jeremy Shockey at nearly 300 pounds. He runs a 4.940.
That football stance trying to take out Showtime.
Because Husky Harris played Division I football at the University of Troy.
And let's not forget, is a third generation superstar. He's also into rodeo and scuba diving. I'd like to see him get into that wetsuit.
Sure you would. Husky Harris is very diverse.
Illegal tag, and the referee doing his job, sending Cody back out the ring, and there's the illegal tag name. MVP.
Swing and a miss.
Big smile crossing Cody's face.
Watch this.
There, Cody telling Husky, watch this. That's how it's done. Textbook. Suplex by Rhodes into the cover. Shoulders down and a kick out by Showtime Watson. Who's going to prevail? This Pros and Rookies tag match continues.
WWE Fatal 4-Way. Three men with nothing to lose. One champion. Champ John Cena defends the WWE Championship against the Viper Randy Orton, the Rated R Superstar Edge, and a Celtic Warrior Sheamus. WWE Fatal 4-Way, the risk is high and the reward even higher. WWE Fatal 4-Way.
The pros have the ability to teach their rookies at the same time in competing and also pick up victories, important victories, for the rookies.
Mentioned before, as the pros and rookies were introduced, that Cody didn't seem too impressed with Husky Harris. But he tags in the near 300 pounder. Rather brawling style that we've seen so far from Harris. And Showtime Watson just hasn't been able to get off the blocks.
Here comes Big Husky Harris!
Gosh!
He might have broken Watson in half.
That's it.
And a kick out by Showtime Percy Watson somehow. You've got to watch this again.
Look at Husky get up in the air, imagine.
And MVP comes in off the tag, and perhaps it's school time for Harris. And MVP, the former United States champion, showing how it's done.
You see the pace of this match just sped up so quickly when MVP tagged himself in. Percy Watson gets out of there.
That was impressive.
And now the ball in Superstar in control.
MVP measuring his man, but Harris could be completely out of it.
Well, MVP setting up for the play of the day on the rookie, Husky Harris.
Look at Cody. And Cody Rhodes.
Well, it was Percy Watson who alerted MVP as to the fact that Cody was going to interject himself into the matchup.
And Cody did just that, and MVP took care of him. And out, showtime. Percy Watson hooks the leg. An impressive victory for the South Beach Pros, MVP and Watson.
Here are your winners, MVP and Showtime, Percy Watson.
I was impressed by both the rookies, Watson and Harris, in that matchup.
Well, Husky Harris looked good. Early on, the near 300-pound rookie, this right here. Look at the elevation.
Oh, man.
By Husky Harris, but you're going to see right here. Percy Watson alerted MVP to the fact that Cody Rhodes was about to descend from the top rope. And as a result of that, MVP tagged in Watson. And Percy, the float over DDT. 3 seconds later, the rookie has his hands raised in the air.
Okay, hang on, hang on. Guys, hang on. Yes, let's get your thoughts on your rookies. Cody, we'll start with you. Your thoughts on Husky Harris.
Husky Harris looks awfully familiar. Not only do you look like someone in my own family, you look like every one of these people. But I don't care to talk about Husky Harris. I want to talk about Showtime. You think you can mold this already great athlete into a WWE pro? Guess what? I'm going to mold this right here into the NXT, the next breakout star.
Thank you, Cody. Obviously frustrated. MVP, your thoughts on the rookies?
Well, Showtime said that he wanted to show me what he can do. I gave him an opportunity. He got himself into some trouble, but he worked his way out of it. Good looking out on the call. So I believe Showtime Percy Watson is ready for prime time.
Okay, thank you very much.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, MVP, I believe, thinks he has a diamond in the rough. Cody Rhodes, as Matt Stryker mentioned, a bit frustrated.
NXT continues to prove to be one of the most unpredictable hours of television. And right now, let's introduce you to another one of our NXT rookies, Mike McGillicuddy.
I am Michael McGillicuddy, and I'm from Champlin, Minnesota. You could call me wrestling royalty. I come from a lineage and a heritage full of champions. My grandfather, the legendary Larry the Axe Hennig. My father, WWE Hall of Famer, Mr. Perfect, Kurt Hennig. I got royal blood running through my veins. It's time for me to make that impact. When I heard that I'm gonna be a part of season 2 of NXT, reality hit that my opportunity is now. It's time for me to shine. I'm gonna be the next WWE breakout star.
NXT is my stepping stone to the next level. If I could describe my in-ring style in one word, it'd be ruthless. I'll ground and pound you if I have to. I remember a time back they called it ruthless aggression. Well, it's back. I was born to do this job. It's up to me to continue the Hennig family legacy.
Ladies and gentlemen, coming up next, we will take you back to one of the most frightening scenes in Monday Night Raw history, the vicious attack on dozens of WWE employees by the 8 graduates of NXT Season 1.
We'd like to take a look now at the vicious and disturbing actions that occurred last night live on Monday Night Raw.
Cena, and here comes John Cena. He's rolling.
Oh, yeah! How about this, C-Nation?
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a visitor. We saw him earlier tonight. That's Wade Barrett. He is the winner of NXT Season 1, that rookie competition, as John Cena looks to put CM Punk away.
And Cena obviously distracted, but there's a five-knuckle shuffle.
John Cena.
Well, this is not good for John, no matter what here.
Well, not at all. Wade Barrett,
you got CM Punk, you got Gallows, Serena.
Kane.
Who's this?
Oh, my Lord. They're all over the place. They're right out here in front of us. Look. It's Slater, Sheffield.
What's going on there, Tekken?
There's chaos at ringside. Young and Slater. These are the rookies from the first season of NXT out here.
Well, Cena got himself some help here. They just taking out his opponent.
Punk?
These guys still with them. Are they still
with them? Look at King. Punk and Gallows are out. They're out here at ringside. And then these 8 rookies who were a part of the NXT first season have surrounded John Cena in the ring.
I don't think they came to make friends with John at all.
My Lord, the ref. John Cena went after Barrett, but ladies and gentlemen, it's 8-on-1. It's a buggy.
You're right.
It is 8-on-1. Oh, my Lord. John Cena's being manhandled.
What are these guys doing here? What is this?
He's down. They're pulling and tearing at him. I mean, like he's a piece of raw meat.
These guys aren't even still with the...
Okay, it's like a pack of dogs. You see, Cena was just reaching out for help. Serious situation. Punk and Gallows are down at ringside as Cena's getting...
It's like a pack of lions. It's awful. What is this? Why?
I have no idea.
They've attacked Punk?
I have no idea what is going on.
For everybody.
This is just... It's inexplicable.
Now, watch out!
Oh my God, Matt Stryker! Matt Stryker just got.
Yeah.
Caval, what are your thoughts on what you just saw? Your predecessors, what did they do on Monday Night Raw? Your thoughts?
Simply unbelievable. It is simply unbelievable that the first season of NXT would do such a thing, but that's how you make a statement here in the WWE.
Lucky Cannon, your thoughts on your predecessors?
Obviously, what they just did was cowardly. I mean, 8-on-1 John Cena, beating up referees, announcers. But like Caval said, if you want to make a statement, that's how you do it.
Husky Harris, the same question. Thank you.
Well, to be honest with you, I don't really agree with everything they did, but I don't really care. Because I'm here to win NXT, and that's it.
Alex Riley, your thoughts? What? That's great. I think you're done. Thank you.
I think I'm allergic to you. Do you mind if...
You know... Percy Watson, your thoughts?
Hey, look here, I don't think that was appropriate behavior at all. You know what I'm saying? If you want to fight a man, you fight that man one-on-one, mano-a-mano, you know what I'm saying? That's what I feel. That's just me, though, you know what I'm saying? Exactly.
Eli Cottonwood.
I think he deserved every bit of it.
Titus O'Neil, your thoughts?
My thoughts are I think that season one come out here and try that with one of us. My thoughts are if you're gonna fight, make it a fight. And if you wanna win, make it a win. But I'll say this, Zack Ryder, if you push me in my chest like you did earlier, John Cena won't be the only one that have to answer.
Okay. Last guy, Michael McGillicuddy, your thoughts?
Hey, first of all, answer the question. A win is a win, and did you just sneeze in the microphone? What is that? The NXT Season 1 guys did make a huge impact, and that's all that matters in this business. That's the same kind of impact.
Thank you very much. Guys, I gotta tell you something. There's a prevailing concern in the locker room for the safety of the men and women that contribute each and every week to what we do here in the WWE. So with that said, on behalf of the WWE pros, on behalf of the locker room, on behalf of all the veterans that paved the way so that we can be in this business, on behalf of everyone that was slaughtered last night live on Monday Night Raw, I would like to officially welcome the NXT rookies to the WWE. Welcome to NXT.
Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. The pros going after the rookies here, and chaos ensuing yet again.
This is an initiation.
And the WWE pros here for the moment showing unity. Going after their rookies here. Officially welcoming these rookies to WWE. Tough times. Adverse times make for strange partners, as you're seeing here.
Well, this is what it's all about, being shown here by the WWE pros.
Well, the pros can unite here tonight, just like we saw the graduates of season one of NXT unite last night. An initiation here tonight. The world's strongest slam, the exclamation point.
Message sent loud and clear to the NXT rookies of season two.
A definite message to quell any possible rebellion.
any possible mutiny as we kick off season number 2 of NXT.